हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम बैक इनटू माय यूट्यूब चैनल प्रोफेसर शोर ऑफ कौर। आई होप यू हैव सीन ऑल माय 6 to 7 वीडियोस ऑन प्रीस्टियस कंक्रीट स्ट्रक्चर इन विच आई डिस्कस्ड डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ टॉपिक्स अलोंग विद सॉल्व्ड न्यूमेरिकल प्रॉब्लम्स इन प्रीस्टियस कंक्रीट। टुडे वी विल लर्न अ न्यू कॉन्सेप्ट, a new design method given by Guyon, scientist Guyon, in prestress concrete structures. So if you have visited my previous video, I have discussed the concept of secondary moments, primary moments and resultant moments in order to analyze statically indeterminate structures in prestressed concrete. Today, in continuation with that, statically indeterminate structures. In continuation to that, today we will study Guyon's method. Guyon's Guyon's theorem. Scientist L. Guyon, he gave this proposal. So our topic was statically indeterminate structures, prestressed structures. So we will start with this topic. Guyon's theorem to determine statically indeterminate structures. If you remember my students, I told that in order to analyze statically indeterminate structures, we had three various methods. First method is method of consistent deformation, Our second method is method of three moment equation, which I discussed in my last video. And the last method, which I told you, that is method of tendon reaction. It is also called Guyon's theorem. This concept is given by scientist Guyon in prestressed concrete structures. So in all the three methods, what we had taken? We had taken a continuous beam, continuous span of prestressed concrete member with tendons passing through it, like this, with tendons passing through it, but we have more than one span. It may be 2 span, it may be 3 span, it may be 5 span, any number of spans with multiple supports, and we used to find out the maximum bending moments. And based on maximum bending moments, we used to find out the stresses in the beam generated. In Guyon's theorem, similarly, it is a different concept, but the target is same. The target is to determine the secondary moments, the primary moments, and the resultant moments. The target is to find out the secondary moments, primary moments, and resultant moments in statically indeterminate structures. That is normal analysis of statically indeterminate structures. Now, First, we have to learn what is the basic theorem. What is the theorem given by Guyon? Guyon told that this principle was, first of all, I tell you, then I will make you write the basic theorem. This principle, this method was suggested by Guyon to determine or to analyze statically indeterminate structures by using one principle. The principle is to replace the tendon action, to replace the tendon action in concrete with equivalent system of loads acting on the concrete. That means the way you are providing tendon inside the concrete, the tendon, the cable profile, we are just removing the tendons, and instead of that we are adding some, removing the tendons, tendon reaction, we are just removing the cables, just, it is a hypothetical concept, we are removing the tendons and we are adding an equivalent amount of load in the prestressed concrete beam. So the method is to, this principle is based on a principle, based on the principle, based on the principle of based on the principle of first based on the principle of replacing based on the principle of replacing the tendon reaction, it is also called, Guyon's theorem is also called tendon reaction method. Tendon, I hope everyone knows what is tendon. Tendon is nothing but the cable, cable of high tensile steel, high tensile steel wires. The tendons are basically the high tensile steel wires which are placed in the prestressed concrete beam in order to impart prestressing in the prestressed beam. Just like if I have a prestressed concrete beam, that means at this end with anchorage or with locks, I provide tendons, right? These are nothing but the cables or tendon. It is also called tendon reaction method. Tendon reaction method. Okay, both the, this is the basic technical name, and since it is given by or proposed by scientist Guyon, that is why it is called Guyon's method. So it is based on the principle of replacing tendon reactions, based on replacing the tendon reactions inside the concrete member, inside pre-stressed concrete member, inside the pre-stressed concrete member with a system of, with a system of equivalent loads, with a system of equivalent loads acting on the beam, acting on the concrete beam. Obviously it is pre-stressed concrete beam. So what we have learned, based on the principle of, the principle starts from here, based on the principle of replacing, very important, that is replacing, we are removing the tendons and we are replacing. It is just like the concept of imparting redundant support in indeterminate structures. If you have learned the basic concept of structural analysis, in redundant structures what we used to do, first we used to impart indeterminacy or redundancy in the support, in the beam with some support, and then we remove the support, and instead of the support we impart or we apply some external reactionary force in the case of SAPO. So similar, the concept is same. If you have studied indeterminate structural analysis, this concept will be very easy to you to understand. Principle of replacing tendon reactions inside pre-stressed concrete members with the system of equivalent loads acting on the concrete beam. It is replacing the tendon, the equivalent acting of concrete beam. Okay. So what we are here doing, the equivalent system of loads, obviously bachcho, my students, equivalent system of loads we have to find out. We have to find out the equivalent system of loads. The equivalent system of loads. The equivalent system of loads will be nothing but equivalent to the tendon reactionary force. The tendon reaction force. It is nothing but equal to tendon reaction force. That means, if we have a beam, a pre-stressed concrete beam, right? We have a pre-stressed concrete beam and we have three supports. Now we are taking continuous span of more than one span. So this reactionary force, whatever they are giving, whatever the reactionary force they give due to the tendons inside the concrete, that we are removing out and we are putting some external loads. Some equivalent loads, right? So we are removing the tendons. The basic concept yahi hai ki we are removing the tendons and we are imparting equivalent loads on the concrete. Ab load aise ho sakta hai ki load can come vertically from upward to downward or from downward to upward, like UDL or point. So that's a different case. But concept yahi hai ki we will remove the pre-stressed wire, equivalent load will come on the concrete, it will be vertically downwards or vertically upwards, right? So the load can be vertically downwards or the load, for example, the load, so the loads can be from up to down or down to up. Okay, so based on the shape of the cable profile, based on the pre-stressing wires, the shape of the pre-stressing wires, the equivalent load can be calculated. So this is the basic principle, bachcho, dimag mein install kar lo. Ye kya hai? Ye kuch nahi hai, bas we are replacing the tendons with equivalent system of loads. Why system? Because it may be UDL only, it may be UDL with concentrated load, it may be UDL with concentrated load with pre-stressing force, that is the axial pre-stressing force, aise jo aata hai. So there may be one or more type of loads. That is why it is called system of equivalent loads. Now under this thing, we will there are also two points under Galois theorem. Under Galois theorem, we have, that is, replacing the tendons replacing the tendons with the pre-stressed concrete member. Replacing the tendons with pre-stressed concrete member supporting the equivalent load, supporting the equivalent system of load, supporting the equivalent system of loads results in finding out, determine the resultant moments, results in determining the resultant moments, right? So what we are doing, we are replacing the tendons with the equivalent system of loads, which results in resultant moments. That means here in this method of analyzing the indeterminate structure, we can directly find out the resultant moments. हम लोग resultant moments हम लोग directly we can find out using the concepts of fixed end methods, using the concept of moment distribution method, using the concept of moment distribution method, using the concept of moment distribution method. Okay, students. So here, unlike in three moment equation, we use three moment equation method. Here we will use the concept of moment distribution method here. Okay. Okay. Now, also we will use the concept of fixed end moments. I told you that in this particular module, in this particular subtopic, we will use the concept of fixed end moments. Okay. Now, I told you that in order to find out the equivalent loads, we have to check the shape of the cable profile inside the concrete member. Obviously, यहाँ पे हम लोग क्या जानते हैं कि first if you find out the resultant moment directly, so no problem. Finding out the resultant moment directly, the secondary moments will be resultant moments minus primary moments. The basic concept which we learned in the very first day under statically indeterminate structures. So, the equivalent system of loads. The tendon reaction. Tendon reactions are associated. The tendon reactions are associated with different types of shapes of cable profile. By and by, slowly I will show in the picture how by using different cable profile we can predict the tendon reactionary force. So the tendon reactions are associated with different types of shapes of cable profile. First you take, this is the first most important thing which we have to remember. That is why it's 3-star. बच्चों 5-star तो मिलता नहीं है अभी. We don't have 5-star chocolate to serve you. That is 3-star. First is straight cable. If we have straight cable, then there will be no reaction. That means no reaction. Straight cable, that means no reaction in the tendon. Second, sharp angle cable, if we have sharp angle cable, then we will take it is as point or concentrated load. First is, if the cable is straight, then we will not take any reactionary force. If the cable is curved, it may be downward, upward, concave, convex. So if it is curved, then we will take it is as, sorry, if it is short angle, then it will be, we will take as point load, right? Third, if it is curved shape, then we will take that it is an UDL. If it is curved shape, then it will take as UDL. And the last is, end anchorage, that is axial thrust with fixed moments. Straight cable, no reaction. Dimag mein, this also you have to install. This concept. Straight cable, no reaction. Sharp angled in cable, then it will be, we have point load or concentrated load. If it is curved, we have UDL. And if it is end anchorages, then axial thrust or fixed moment. Basically, we will get the point 1, 2, and 3. This we will basically get in the problems में देखोगे कि mainly हम लोग को पहला जो तीन कंडीशन से वो ही ज्यादातर questions पे आता है. The first three types of condition usually maximum have high chances to come in any numerical problem. Okay, so this first you take down, you just pause the video and take down the notes. Now coming to the diagrammatic or the schematic view. Coming to the schematic view, the things which I have written here, now I will show them in the diagram form. Now shapes. Various shapes of cable profile. Now consider first we have a beam. Pre-stressed concrete beam, and we have, let us say I am taking the basic one, the basic intermediate structure, that is two span beam. We have support A, B and C. Okay, so A, B and C are the three supports and this is the pre-stressed beam. Now I will show the different shape of the cable profile. Let me take first, so I have anchorage here. Let me see. So my cable profile, the red color is the cable profile. First, Vachu, you have to understand that. Let me take the red line as the cable profile. And this is R1. This is R2. Right? So I have one curved, second curved, one sharp. So what are the things? The first is one curved profile. Second, this is the second curved profile. This is the, you may call as sharp jump, sharp angle, and this is the flat portion, flat straight portion. Okay. So figure 1, figure 2, figure 3, figure 4. You may take either figure 3 and figure 4. Okay. Figure 3 and figure 4. So first side mein kya hai? First you have the radius of curvature r1. Here the radius of curvature is r1, right? So r1 is the radius of curvature. Radius of curvature of curve 1. Okay, right? So from down to up we have the curve. So obviously when we have the radius of curvature like this, then the equivalent load will be, see everyone, the equivalent load will be P by R. Okay, I haven't shown the pre-stressing force. Let me see, this is the pre-stressing force. But P is the pre-stressing force. P is the pre-stressing force. Okay, P is the pre-stressing force. So now for the curved one, R1 is the radius of curvature. The equivalent load will be P by R1. Obviously, the radius of the equivalent load will be P by R1. Second radius of curvature is the parabolic. This part, figure 2. The figure 2 is parabolic. Figure 3 is sharp angle. Sharp angle in cable. Sharp angle in cable, right? So now we have to, so यहाँ पे रुकने का कोई मतलब नहीं है. We should not stop here. We have to check the diagram or shape of the cable, and then we have to draw the equivalent load system. Mind my student, we have to draw the equivalent load system. One thing here, I am not considering there is any external load. Let me consider there is no external load here. But in numerical problem, you will get question on, you have external loads, that is live load and dead load, and also the equivalent load system which you have to find out. Here in this figure, I am not considered external load. Not considered external load. That is no dead load, live load is there. I am just considering. So we have to find out the equivalent load system. We have to find out the equivalent load system, right? So this will be my equivalent load system diagram. Please write down, my students. Bachcho, dheere dheere, go on continuously. Take down the notes which I am writing on the board. Bahut important hai, exam mein aayega. 1000% confirm question. Equivalent load system diagram. Equivalent load system diagram. Right? Now you have to concentrate here. Yahan pe concentrate karo bachcho. Here you concentrate. Now we have first in there, the thing is we have the downward curve. Obviously we have the downward curve till this section. So the UDL will be from up to down. The UDL will be from up to down. Okay, students, this is for figure part 1, that is UDL. Why it is UDL? Because I told you, if there is curve, then we will have UDL. Just see the point. If it is curve, then we will have, we'll assume it is UDL as equivalent load. Similarly, bachcho, is portion mein, check this portion. So from this to this point, we have a upward UDL. We have a UDL coming from top to from downwards, because the curve is in the upper section. If you take this as centroid, centroidal axis, this is the upper curve. So upper curve meaning the load is at the from downward. The load is downwards, from upward to downwards. Now we have point load, right? We have the sharp edge, so we will have some point load. Let it be P2. Sharp angle, sharp jump, sharp angular diagram. Then we will have a concentrated load. Obviously, it is below the centroid, below the centroidal axis. Meaning, obviously, it is from down to up. This concentrated load, and we have this one, the straight part. So we will have here P, pre-stressing force, and the moment PE. Obviously, everywhere we will have PE. If there, obviously we have eccentricity here, first it is straight, so no reaction, but we have the pre-stressing force here, so we have pre-stressing force, and due to the eccentricity we have P into E, that is the moment coming due to pre-stressing force and eccentricity. So this is the whole thing. पहले क्या है हमको देखना है, कर्व है कि शार्प एंगुलर है या स्ट्रेट लाइन है और कहां पे है. इफ इट इज बिलो द सेंट्रॉइड देन आई टू वी विल पुट यूडीएल बिलो. इफ इट इज कर्व अपवर्ड एट द टॉप और ऑन द टॉप ऑफ द बीम. इफ दिस कर्व इज बिलो ऑब्वियसली दिस विल बी बिलो द यूडीएल. नेक्स्ट द शार्प जंप, सो पॉइंट लोड. Why the point load? Now how we will put the point load? The sharp jump is below the centroidal axis, so the point load is from down to up, and the last is the pre-stressing force. And I missed one thing, that is for UDL. For UDL, the equivalent load. For UDL, the equivalent load WE will be nothing but 8 PE by L square. How? Because we know that M equals to W square by 8, which is nothing but moment is equals to PE. So from this it is coming. How it is coming, bachcho? What is maximum bending moment? Maximum bending moment is W square by 8 for UDL. That is nothing but PE. Moment is equals to PE in pre-stressing force. So just cross multiply, you will get the equivalent UDL load. You will get the equivalent UDL load on the structure. So this is the basic concept in Guyon's theorem, which I have mentioned in my statement form. This is the diagrammatic form, the previous verse in the statements. Now we will do one problem. Now we will do one problem. Numerical problem on Guyon's method. Guyon's theorem. Numerical problem on Guyon's theorem. The question says that a continuous pre-stress beam, first we will start with the problem statement. The problem statement is The continuous beam ABC where AP and BC have the same lengths. AB 10 meter and BC is also 10 meter. And it is parabolic cable. The tendon profile, the tendon or cable profile, the tendon or cable profile is parabolic. It is parabolic throughout. Obviously, my students, if you get such questions on Guyon's theorem, be rest assured that the diagram of the cable profile in the pre-stressed concrete will be given. The diagram of the cable profile of pre-stressed concrete will be given. So, parabolic curve, parabolic shape throughout the length. Mind it, it is written throughout the length. I will draw the diagram now. Throughout the length. Throughout the length. Now, the effective pre-stressing force. The effective pre-stressing force is given 200 kN. Again, dead load is given. Dead load is given 0.24 kN per meter. Live load is given 2.36 kN per meter. Okay. Live load is given 2.36 kN per meter. Dead load is given 0.24 kN per meter. Please pause karke video, pause karke you take the problem. Now the question they are asking is that calculate the resultant moments. We have to calculate the resultant moments RM. I am writing short. Okay, bachu? Calculate the resultant moments developed in the beam. Calculate the resultant moments developed in the beam and इसके साथ और एक क्वेश्चन रहेगा. देयर विल बी वन एसोसिएटेड क्वेश्चन. द फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन विल बी ऑब्वियसली टू फाइंड आउट द रिजल्टेंट मोमेंट्स. द सेकंड क्वेश्चन विल बी टू लोकेट द प्रेशर लाइन. लोकेट द प्रेशर लाइन, द थ्रस्ट और प्रेशर लाइन पी लाइन इन द बीम, इन द कॉन्टिन्यूअस बीम A, B. So, the question is very simple. It is a very short question. It is not very lengthy also. It is a very simple and short question. Calculate the resultant moments developed in the beam and also locate the pressure line or thrust line. Obviously, students, we have to find out the pressure line or thrust line in order to show the reactionary force. The point, what is pressure line? What is pressure line, bachcho? We know that this pressure line or thrust line is nothing but the path or the trajectory of the force of application of reaction due to tendons. This pressure line is nothing but the path or you can say the trajectory. The path or trajectory of the resultant forces acting inside the beam due to tendon reaction. Okay, so thrust line or P line, both are same. They represent the resultant forces acting inside the beam due to the reactionary force acting inside the high tensile wires in bundle form, that is called tendons. So now this is the problem. First I will draw the diagram. So pause the video and take down the question. Okay. The diagram is like this. First, I will draw the diagram. Students, be very accurate while drawing the diagram. Be very conscious also. Be very concentrated. So we have three support beam. Let me take its A, B, C. This is the centroidal axis. We all know this is the neutral axis or centroidal axis. The tendon shape is like this. The tendon shape or this cable profile is like this, and we have the external loads coming, which is acting on the beam. Let this is G, 0.24 kN per meter, and we have live load. Okay, so we have the parabolic, you can see we have the parabolic curved cable profile, and also see there is no eccentricity of the pre-stressing force at the anchorage zone or at the juncture or at the ends. So there is no pre-stressing, there is no eccentricity at the juncture. Mind it, no eccentricity at the anchorage zone. At the anchorage zone, no eccentricity at the anchorage zone, but we have the maximum eccentricity of 100 mm for the curved profile. Okay, so now first, so this is the thing, this is the cable profile diagram, right? This is, you may call as the cable profile diagram. Cable profile diagram plus external loads. This is the cable profile diagram plus the external loads. Okay. So first we have to find out the total external load. So therefore, so this is the cable profile diagram with the external loads. Now from the beam diagram, we have to derive the equivalent system of load figure, the figure which is representing the equivalent system of loads. So what we need here, we have dead load and live load. So total external load in this case is G plus Q, 0.24 plus 2.36, which is coming about 2.6 kN per meter, which will be downwards. You have to jot down the load first. So total external load will be dead load plus live load. Second is the equivalent load. The equivalent system of load, the equivalent system of load, the system of load, that is UDL, if we take as WE, if we take as WE, that is nothing but 8PE by L square. The equivalent system of loads, because we have only the curve profile, and also we have the curve profile below the centroid. For AB also, for BC also, we have the curve profile below the centroid. So that means we have to remember that since it is below the centroid, the UDL, that means the equivalent load will be from upwards, down to up. The equivalent load, let us calculate, 8P multiplied with E, E is 100 mm by L square, 8P by L square, that is coming 1.6 kN per meter, that is upward. So the equivalent load 1.6 kN per meter is upward. So we have to now draw the diagram. Right? So we have A, B and C, three supports, obviously as before. Right? So the figure we will be the equivalent system of loads. So the figure B will be the equivalent system of loads. That means we have the UDL downwards, which is 1.6 kN per meter. Right? So we have the downward UDL and also we have the upward UDL. That is nothing but dead load plus live load. It is nothing but the dead load plus live load. So this is the equivalent diagram for equivalent system of loads. This is the diagram for the equivalent system of loads. So by taking this diagram, now we have to calculate the resultant moments and also the location of pressure line. So we have, see here, we have downward load 2.6 coming from top to bottom and 1.6 bottom to upward. So what will be the resultant load? So therefore, the resultant load, will be equals to the downward load minus the upward load. That is, we have 1.0 kN per meter is the resultant UDL. Now see, we have ABC moments, we have support A, B and C. So we know the fixed end moment, we have the fixed end moments at end supports. We know that whenever there is UDL, coming from basic concept of structural analysis, the fixed end moment at end supports will always be WL square by 12, that is, so we are taking as resultant UDL, WR, so WR L square by 12, that is the fixed end moments, very fixed end moments. Okay, so that will be equals to fixed end moment of AB is equals to minus fixed end moment of BA. All are same. Fixed end moment of BC equals to fixed end moment of CB. So we have 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 end moments, all W squared by 12. Right? Now, the resultant moments here. Resultant moments. If you see the total beam, if you see the total beam span ABC, moments that A is simply supported, C is simply supported, we know that the bending moment at simply supported are 0. The bending moment at simply supported ends will be 0. So MA equals to MC equals to 0. While MB will be nothing but WR L square by 8. So put the value 1 L square by 8. That is coming 12.5 kN per meter. Please make this a box. So now from the basic concept of resultant moments, ABC are the simply supported beams, A is the end support, C is the end support, so we have the bending moment 0 and end support, and the intermediate support we have WR L square by 8. Now how this is coming? Bahut sara student mujhe puchta hai, many students they ask me, sir ye kaise aata hai, how this is coming? How this is the intermediate support is coming as WR L square by 8. Ab bachcho dekho yahan pe, is nothing but moment distribution concept. Moment distribution. Right? So moment distribution, what we have? The basic concept is first is, let me take the we have A. Let me take the beams AB, we have BA, we have BC, and we have CB. Right? We have AB, BA, BC, and CB. So now we are coming to the moment distribution chart. Right? Now, the moment distribution chart, if you see the distribution factor DF. The distribution factor for BA and BC is 0.5. That means B is the common support, and we have the total UDL acting on it. So we may now imagine that the result in this 1 kN per meter is only acting UDL. We don't have now the UDL. Now if I subtract 2.6 minus 1.6 will be only 1 kN per meter. 1 kN per meter UDL. Okay, so if we have this continuous UDL and we have the intermediate support B, the distribution factor will be 0.5. Agar bachcho bhul gaye ho, if you have forgotten the moment distribution concept, just go back to any old chapter structure analysis and any book you follow, you just go through the moment distribution chapter. So right now is 0.5. So fixed end moment, if we take the FEM as a fixed end moment, for AB we have minus W square by 12 BA have plus W square by 12 similarly BC we have W square by 12 and CB plus W square by 12. So this is the basic, first this is the basic fixed end moment, basic fixed end moment values which I have shown here. One end will be 1 minus, one end will be plus, like this. If you consider, let me, I am showing you for one beam AB, okay. So this will be minus W square by 12
and this will be plus W square by 12. Okay,
so this is a fixed moment, right?
Now we have the balancing. Now we will have the balancing. Okay, we'll balancing. So this will turn into plus W square by 12, right? Plus balancing plus W square by 12. Sorry, minus. Minus will be plus. Plus will be minus. This is the balancing, right? And the third is carry over. Third is carry over. So this will be carry over to this, multiplied with distribution factor. So we will get one value here into distribution factor. This will be plus W square by 24, and this is minus W square by 24. We have the rho considering the fixed end moment. We have rho considering the balancing. We are multiplying the balancing moment with distribution factor. We have got one. Obviously, this will be transferred to from ends to the intermediate beams, right? Carry over, this is a carry over. And last, we will add this one. Last, we will add this one. This, we will add this. And obviously, for BC also, we will add this thing, right? So, if you add these two, you will get the value of W square by 8. If you add the moments for BA and BC, BA will be, these are both plus. So this will be plus W square by 8, and for BC it will be minus W square by 8. That means at the intermediate support B, considering two beams BA and BC, they are, the summation of these two moments is 0. That is why MB is W square by 8. That is nothing but the resultant moment. Okay, that is nothing but the resultant moment. So this is the resultant moment at the support B. At the support B, the resultant moment. Obviously, we have to check the resultant moment at mid-span. See, there are two zones where bending moment is non-zero. First is at the intermediate point B and two center spans. That is the mid-half or the mid-span section of AB and BC. We are not interested with A and C because I told you the moment at A and C is 0. Now coming to the figure or calculating the resultant moment. Calculating the resultant moment. Resultant moment at mid span section for both the spans, the resultant moment at mid span section for both the mid spans will be WR L square by 8 minus WR L square by 16. So completely it is coming as WR L square by 16. So put this value. We have 1 into L, that is 10 square, divided by 16, which is coming as plus 6.25 kilonewton meter. So we are getting the resultant moment at mid-span as WR square by 16, that is 6.25 kilonewton meter, right? So finally, we have to calculate the location of pressure line. So we have calculated this one, and we have calculated again for moment B. That is plus 12.5 kilonewton meter, that is MB. So location of pressure line, coming back to the basics, location of pressure line first is at section. After finding out the distance of the pressure line at every section, finally we will draw the diagram. So that will be the end of your problem. At section A, and C, moment is zero. So therefore, shift of pressure line at A and C both are zero. That is, if you take the beam at A and C, just like the cable profile was concentric at the centroidal axis, the pressure line will be concentric. Now at section of midspan, of AB and BC both are similar, so we will find out shift of pressure line will be how much? M by P. The basic formula we all know, to find out the pressure line we got to get the M by P, because what we know, M is P into E, E1, E dash. Now let us, M is M, the moment is nothing but pressure into the pre-stressing force, not pressure, the pre-stressing force multiplied with the eccentricity, that is the eccentricity of the pressure line, that is nothing but the E dash. I am not representing E, because E represents that for tendons. E represents for tendons, and E dash I am representing separately for the shift line. So find the, for mid span the minimum was 6.25. So 6.25 into 10 to the power 3 divided by 200, we are getting plus 31.25 mm. Which is for the above centroidal axis. So the shift of pressure line at mid-span is 31.25 mm above the centroidal axis. Last, at section B. Shift of pressure line at B. The shift of pressure line again M by P. The bending moment is this one, 12.5 multiplied with 10 to the power 3 divided by 200, we are getting plus 62.5 mm below centroidal axis, below neutral axis or the centroidal axis. See, first is, so at section B, the shift of pressure line or the location of pressure line is 62.5 mm below the centroidal axis. Now, based on this value, you will draw the diagram. So let me here, in this I am drawing the diagram here only. So finally this will be your task, to draw the pressure line. This is support A, support B, support C. This is 10 meter, again BC is 10 meter. we have to show the centroidal axis. We have to show the centroidal axis, right? Okay. So now, first find out, we will just draw the pressure line, okay? We will draw the pressure line diagram. Pressure line diagram, P line diagram, okay? Pressure line diagram. So what is shift at A and C, 0? So A and C will be 0. At mid-span, coming to mid-span, we have 31.25. So obviously we will have 31.25 mid-span. And at B, 62.5 below. So this will be like something like this. This is nothing but the P line. You have to show here, this is P line, and also you have to show the diagram. Not the diagram, but also the distance, 31.25 mm, and this 62.5. So now at mid span, I told you our value we got is 31.25 above centroidal axis. So above centroidal axis here, above centroidal axis here. At B, 62.5 mm below centroidal axis. So at B, this C, if we check the B, just at the axis of B support, 62.5 mm below the centroidal axis. So this is how you have to calculate and meet structures using Guyon's theorem. Practically, my students all over universities in India, questions practically come from two methods: theorem of three moment and Guyon's method. Okay, so this is how you will solve. If you have gone through my videos, I hope you will excel in examination, and obviously your concepts are strengthened, and you will come out from examination hall with flying colors. Thank you, my students. I love you all. And please, 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 bahut sara likes chahiye, bahut sara likes chahiye. Likes, comments, and subscribe. Please, my friends, my students, my seniors, whoever is watching these videos, please subscribe these videos so that, and share these videos more and more, because if you have seen my past videos, बहुत कॉन्सेप्चुअल लेक्चर्स है ये जो प्रीस्टेस कॉन्क्रीट का जो लेक्चर्स है बच्चों ये बहुत बहुत कॉन्सेप्चुअल है दिस कॉन्सेप्ट यू विल नेवर गेट फ्रॉम एनी बुक दिस कॉन्सेप्ट आर नॉट डिस्कस्ड इन एनी बुक सो माय फ्रेंड्स सिंस प्रीस्टेस कॉन्क्रीट इज अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट सब्जेक्ट इन सिविल इंजीनियरिंग तो आई वॉन्ट यू टू सब्सक्राइब शेयर एंड मोर वीडियोज आर देयर फॉर यू to learn the basic concepts of pre-stressed concrete. Thank you. Stay home. Stay safe. Jai Hind. I'll be by your side.